Welcome back to Our Community. Susie Thomas speaking with Dr. Suzanne Nicholson. She is with Malone University, and particularly today talking about the She Leads Summit coming up. When and where, Suzanne?
It is October 28th. That's a Saturday, and it is from 11:30 in the morning until 5 o'clock in the evening at the Johnson Center in the dining room. And you need to register online because there is a fee that's attached with it. It's $65 for the day. And so that includes all of the talks that you hear. It includes lunch, and it includes a free book that you receive. It's the book launch is for... I've got to find my notes here. The book launch is for Tara Beth Leach's new book, published by InterVarsity, called Emboldened, Ooh. A Vision for Empowering Women in Ministry. So you get that free book as well as lunch, plus all the speakers for the $65 fee.
That's and so a bargain.
It is. I think it's a bargain, absolutely. And so you can either go to malone.edu/sheleads. Or Missio Alliance is the organization that we are partnering with. They are the ones who are putting on the summit, and then we are one of the regional venues. So you can go to missioalliance.org/sheleads as well.
Tell me about Missio Alliance. What's this organization that I was misreading as Mission Alliance?
Yes, if you type it in your lovely autocorrect,
it did.
It'll take care of that for you. And then you go, wait a sec, it's not Mission Alliance, it's Missio Alliance. And yes, on one hand, I'm from Malone, and so I'm not, you know, from the organization. I don't want to misrepresent them. Mm-hmm. But my understanding of Missio Alliance is that their desire is to really engage the cultural issues that are facing the evangelical church and to really offer some theological and practical direction for pastors and leaders, just for anyone who's needing clarity on issues of scriptural authority or the incarnational nature of the church, discipleship, spiritual formation, the robustness of the gospel, all of those kinds of questions. And in particular, with this conference for She Leads, they want to encourage women in leadership in the church.
Before the break, we were starting to talk about getting overextended and how part of leadership, I love that you said part of leadership is learning to say no and being able to set some boundaries. Help us out. Help us peel this back a little bit. You're a busy mom. Your kids are in busy years.
They're in high school. Yes.
Those are busy years. And there you are, you know, a college professor, you're a professional woman, you are, you know, you've got the whole enchilada to take care of. How do you figure out navigating what do I take on, what do I not take on? How do I decide if this is the season for this or does this wait for another season? How do we do that?
How do we do that? Well, I think part of the balance, I want to give my husband a plug here because we're in this together. And I think that's part of what Missio Alliance is trying to do with this She Leads Summit is to say it's men and women partnering together in leadership in the church. And so the things that I do, I could not do without my husband being supportive. And so, you know, that means that we share responsibilities in taking care of the kids. And so, you know, some days he's taking the kids to the doctor appointment and some days I'm doing it. You know, some days, you know, I do the laundry and he folds the laundry. I mean, we split things up so that we're helping with the housework. We're helping with driving the kids from point A to point B. And so, you know, we're a team as we do this. And so that means when I want to take on a new thing, sometimes I say to him, Lee, I'm like, can I take this on? I'm like, this sounds really exciting.
Yeah.
And so he'll say, yeah, that sounds great. You should do that. Or he'll say, well, let's look at our schedules. And maybe that's not the best week to do that because, you know, he's a youth pastor. And so he's like, well, right. I've got a ministry thing at the church this week. And maybe that's not the best week. So it's always that partnering together to determine, you know, whether we can do these things.
Interesting that people are starting to put together men and women leading together in ministry, in the church. What, from your perspective, what unique thing do women bring to the table in ministry?
Ooh, that's, I keep saying this every time you ask me a question, that's such an interesting question.
Well,
I think
thanks.
it kind of depends on the woman,
yes,
who it is, because I mean, you could go with sort of typical stereotypes,
right,
you know, about women being more compassionate or emotional or willing to develop consensus. But I think, again, that's a stereotype and that's not true. And that makes it sound like men are not compassionate or not emotional or not willing to engage in consensus. So I kind of want to avoid that a little bit. But certainly we have different experiences and And again, different cultural experiences. You know, what it means to be a woman in this culture is different than what it means to be a man. And some of the, even some of the expectations, you know, whether it's the way that we look, for example, and all of the advertising about, you know, makeup and fashion and, you know, hairstyles and all of these things, you know, there's certain pressures that, that we have to face that maybe don't men don't face in the same way, although they have similar pressures, but it's in a different manner. And so sometimes it's just bringing that perspective to the table that says, you know, if you talk about it like X, you know, it's going to come across in the wrong way, mm-hmm. or you're putting more pressure on women, or if you tell that joke from the pulpit, that's not really funny to women, or, you know, those kinds of things. So sometimes it's just having that balance and that mm-hmm. that conversation together.
I think it's interesting that in the 21st century, we're still talking about women in leadership. Have you run into any roadblocks of people saying women in leadership, but the Bible says that women are not supposed to be in leadership?
Sure, all the time. Yep. It depends on the circles that I'm in. So I'm mm-hmm. in the United Methodist Church, and we've been ordaining women for a long time. Mm-hmm. And I am an ordained deacon in the United Methodist Church. And for us, the deacons are basically serving in the world, and then we partner back to the church. And so because I'm a university professor, that's why I'm a deacon. If my primary calling were to order the church, then I would be an elder. But because I'm out in the world and bridging back, that's why I'm a deacon. And so in the Methodist Church, I haven't had as many of those issues because for years we've been ordaining women. But in other circles, I'll definitely come up, you know, I'll have come across those questions, and people will say, well, what about this scripture? What about that scripture? And I'll say, well, let's sit down. Let's talk about the context of these scriptures, because as I tell my students, context is everything. Mm-hmm. I say, if you learn one thing from me, learn context is everything. And so that means the historical context is very important. And that doesn't mean, oh, it's something that's 2,000 years old, we can just throw it out. It doesn't mean that at all.
No, that's not what you're saying.
But it means we need to understand what was going on in the church at the time that, you know, Paul said that. Or, right, exactly. And when we understand that context, mm-hmm. We see the limited application that it has for that particular moment in that particular church. And in other places, especially, you know, when you balance that, you have to look at what else Paul says. And Paul
right.
refers to Junia as an apostle. Paul, you know, talks about Phoebe. Paul talks about all of these other women who are co-workers, you know, with him
yes.
for the gospel. And so you have to balance out those statements with other things. And we could do a lot of shows on interpretation of scripture. And so I'd be happy
to
sit down and do that. But you have to take things in context. And so, mm-hmm. you know, happy to have those conversations. And sometimes we have those conversations at Malone. One of the things I appreciate that we do there is we have the Worldview Forum. And so we talk about issues like that. In fact, I was one of the speakers for a forum on women in leadership. I don't know if it was 6 months ago or when it was. And what we try to do there is model civil dialogue. In this day and age, in this culture, you know, people are trolls on Facebook and they say terrible things and they say it in a horrible way. And we see that in the political climate as well. Mm-hmm. And so we have not learned to talk civilly with one another and say, okay, maybe you don't think that women in leadership is a biblical prescription. I tend to think that it is. I think it's biblical. I'm not throwing out the Bible. I think this is absolutely biblical, what God desires for men and women. Mm-hmm. Let's sit down and have a conversation about it. Not scream and yell, not call each other names, but let's really look at things carefully. And so I think that's really important to be able to do in this day and age.
Mm-hmm. We're talking about She Leads, the summit. It's taking place. Tell us again where and when and how we get tickets to
it. It is Saturday, October 28th from 11:30 in the morning until 5 o'clock in the afternoon at Malone University in the Johnson Center dining room. And you do need to register in advance. It is $65 for the day. And you can register at malone.edu/SheLeads.
If there is a takeaway that you hope people acquire from attending or even from listening to this morning, what would that be?
It would be that God desires all people to fulfill their God-given gifts and their God-given calling, and that men and women both have a calling to leadership, and that we all have a calling to preach the gospel. women were the first to preach the risen Christ. They were at the empty tomb, and they went and they told the disciples, he is alive. That is preaching the gospel. And had they not done that, you know, the disciples would have been, you know, they would have been very confused for quite a while, you know. Yeah. And then Jesus appears, and Jesus, you know, sends women as well as men. And so let's not hold back anybody who wants to preach the gospel. Let's empower people to talk about Jesus as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and mm-hmm. what that means for our lives. How is Jesus Lord of our life? We should all be having that conversation.
What was it that compelled you to do what you're doing now?
Jesus would be the simple answer. I actually started out, I had a journalism degree, and I started out as a newspaper reporter. And I, for a long time, like I said, my mom had modeled for me faith. And so when I was in high school, I had started reading the Bible. I started with Genesis 1:1 and started reading through the Bible because I thought if I'm a Christian, I should know what that means. And so when I was a journalism major in college and started out as a newspaper reporter, I liked what I was doing, but I didn't feel fulfilled. Mm. And as I prayed about it, I said, well, what is the thing that really, you know, gets me excited? And I realized it was my faith. And so that started me on a journey of pursuing seminary and really asking God to reveal to me, you know, where I was called. And initially I thought it was to be a pastor. I was going to be a United Methodist pastor in a church. And then the more that I prayed about it, I realized, no, I was called to teaching and to discipleship as a university level professor. And so that meant doing PhD work and lots of study. But it was that sort of step by step, you know, being faithful to each step, and then God revealed more, and then God revealed more. And so, yeah, so that's how I came to be a professor at Malone.
Well, we're so grateful. If people want more information, how do they contact you or the college to find out more?
Yes, you can contact me. That's snicholson@malone.edu, snicholson@malone.edu, and I can answer any questions they have.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Suzanne Nicholson, and it's She Leads Summit. Thanks for all you're doing in our community.
Thank you so much, Susie.